Hi, my name is Dr. Padilla. I am a professor in computer science and psychology, and I have been a faculty member for over 5 years now. I have been working on this little mini series that is all about giving you advice and tips about applying to graduate school. And today I wanted to talk about if you are deciding between a PhD program and a master's program, which one might be a best fit for you. Now, there are many things to think about when trying to decide between the two types of programs. And the first thing I want to talk about is how they are similar. There are several similarities, and it depends based on individual departments and individual programs. But what I tend to see is that the master's program is often the first 2 years or 1 year of a PhD program. So in terms of the coursework, they can be quite similar. We're going to be learning similar things. What happens with a master's is you stop the point at which you begin to develop your own academic or intellectual research. You're really just getting the foundational skill sets, and that's sort of the end. There might be a capstone or thesis project, but it's really about completing those courses and completing the kind of seminal thesis that you would need to complete that particular degree for the master's. But the courses can often be the same, if not actually the same courses. So you might find yourself in courses with other PhD students in some cases. So in terms of what you're learning, you are going to have very similar courses, but you're not going to be allowed as much time to intellectually develop in a master's program as you would with a PhD program. So that is something to think about, is actual skills that you would gain. Of course, they're shorter. Master's degree is 2 years. A PhD can be 5 to 6, sometimes 7 years. So there's certainly just less you can do in a master's degree. It's often very, very quick. You will want to try to finish your master's degree in 2 years, but I very frequently see people drag it out a little bit to 3 years sometimes, just because it is so challenging to cram all of those courses in a short period. So be aware that that is something that I've seen very frequently that happens, that it actually takes a little bit longer than 2 years or sometimes 1 year to get completed based on the particular program. But when thinking about the length of courses or the time that you spend in each of these two things, something I want you to consider, especially look for this if you're in your undergraduate degree now, is a lot of programs have this ability to do a master's as their fifth year of their undergrad. If this is available to you, jump on it. It is essentially where after you complete your undergraduate degree, you could take a single additional year and get a master's degree. Usually there's a little bit of a financial benefit to doing this, and you can complete it in a year, which is amazing. So I encourage everyone who has this in their program, just go ahead and do it. Honestly, don't think too much about it. Go ahead and do it. And if you want another master's degree and something else, do that too. I'm not saying throw around your money, but you know, I have 2 master's degrees. And everyone I've known who has done this situation where they took the fifth year to get their master's thought it was so incredibly worth it. Great use of time, great use of resources. Once you leave the program, you will not be able to access that program or courses anymore. And it's not open to anyone. It's really just for the undergrads that are graduating from that program. So it's a very special opportunity. Another element that might make them a little bit similar for a PhD and a master's is there's oftentimes master's degrees that have a research element to it. So you often have to complete a thesis project that has a research component, which means you might be working in a lab. You might have actually had to apply to work with a specific lab. And to graduate, you have to complete a research project. So that could be a component of your master's degree, but that is not guaranteed. So you need to be very careful when you're selecting master's versus PhD to know if that is an element of it, because it is a very valuable opportunity. And the last way that they're similar is that you will be interacting with very similar professors in these two types of programs. Oftentimes the professors who are teaching PhD courses in the department are going to be the same people who might be teaching some of these master's courses. So if you're wanting to be able to connect with these famous, exciting professors, both programs will give you access to some degree to work with these individuals. Okay, so let's talk about how these programs are different now. There's a lot of differences. Obviously, a time difference, 2 years for a master's or 1 year, and then 5 to 6 years for a PhD. That's a clear difference. Along with that comes this very peculiar difference in the financials. So for the master's degree, you pay for everything. All of the courses, all of the additional student fees, everything out of pocket, and it can be very expensive, especially if you're out of state, out of country, etc. That is a very big financial commitment. But for the PhD, you have a contract that you sign when you go in, and you usually get your salary covered and the courses covered. So it's free to you in some ways. And then you get a salary for doing this additional work of being a teaching assistant or working as a research assistant. So it's almost a better financial deal to go into the PhD program. And many PhD programs have this thing called a mastering out, which is that if you need to stop midway, maybe you have personal reasons why you can't complete the degree or it's not working out. 2 years or 3 years in, you can complete some additional requirements and leave with your master's. So you didn't leave with nothing. That essentially means that you could have applied straight to the master's program and paid entirely for that program out of pocket. Or if you got into the PhD program, you can be working towards your PhD, and if it doesn't work out and you want to get your master's, you can leave with the master's, but then you didn't pay for everything and they paid you a salary to be a teaching assistant or work on research. If you can get into a PhD program, I highly recommend it from a financial standpoint, simply because it'll make a little bit more sense. But of course, you have to be a teaching assistant, you have to do research. So it's kind of up to you if that works for you or not. If you're in a paid master's program, then you can, you know, have whatever job you want. There's no commitment about the type of work that you do. You can keep your current job and just continue your master's, and that is fine. So that is definitely something to consider. The other thing that's important is that each of these two degrees will give you access to different types of jobs. For a PhD, if you want to do anything in academia, it's pretty good to have a PhD. Of course, if you want to be a professor like myself, you need a PhD. If you want to teach courses, you need a PhD. There's a pretty small subset of professions outside of academia that require a PhD. Oftentimes, if there's a research focus to the position and you want to be in charge of a lab or, you know, the research arm, research branch of an industry, then a PhD can be helpful. It's not always required, but it's usually just helpful. Many times, people who have a master's degree but just show an extreme level of proficiency and lots of excellent productivity can make it to those same places that a PhD can get to. So if you're thinking about being fully industry, you don't necessarily need a PhD, and most jobs will allow you to have a master's degree, but just show, you know, a certain level of productivity to get to the same level that a PhD candidate would be at. It would be a little bit easier with a PhD, sure, but I wouldn't say it's strictly necessary. There's not really many jobs that it is strictly necessary. I will say I've known some people who have mastered out, kind of quit their PhD along the way. They've ended up being more successful than many of the PhDs that I know. So it's not required to get a PhD, and it's truly not for everyone, and it might not even be necessary for you. Apart from do you need it or not, it's pretty fun process. I truly enjoyed my PhD, and I love being in academia. So there might be just personal reasons why you want to get a PhD, and that is absolutely fine. I really enjoyed the time to grow as a scholar. I thought that I needed more time than I think I would have had with just a master's degree, in part because I needed to really kind of develop and grow as academic myself. So I feel very lucky for that opportunity. I think it would have been very rushed with a master's, but it's totally up to you, of course. I have 2 master's degrees and 1 PhD, so I've seen lots of different ways to do it. And I truly enjoy education, and you might as well. I hope this was a helpful discussion. Like I say, there's no right or wrong answer. You really have to decide for yourself. Getting a PhD isn't necessary for a lot of things, but it can be very rewarding nonetheless. And there could be a financial reason you might want to get your PhD. But of course, getting a master's degree is an excellent opportunity as well. If you have any more questions about applying to graduate school or want to talk more about these topics, please comment down below. I will try to make more videos to address specific comments that you have. Thank you for watching to the end, and take care.